Hi guys, welcome to Naresha Technologies. This is Subrazu. In this video session, we can view a detailed software development life cycle. It is popularly known as system development life cycle. Every software engineer should have minimum idea what happening in the real-time industry in the live project analysis. Each and every step is the most important. You are a developer, you are a designer, you are a programmer, or you are a database engineer. Definitely this session is helping you more and a lot. So try to involve clearly each and every area. So we'll start with software development life cycle. First, let me explain clear phases. Feasibility study, analysis, designing, coding, testing, delivery and maintenance. These are the six phases existed as per IEEE standards. IEEE means Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. It is world number one organization for documentation of project environment. As per the IEEE standards, once again I am repeating six phases. Feasibility study, analysis, designing, coding, testing, delivery and maintenance. So these are the six phases. Let me allow to explain each and every phase clearly in a simple way or from the client location. To study business requirements, business analyst team follows TELOS formula, TELOS. T represents technical feasibility or technology feasibility. E represents economic feasibility. L represents legal feasibility. O represents operational feasibility. S represents schedule feasibility. By following this TELOS, business analyst team preparing in-detailed high-level document is called BDD. Business design document. It contains only client requirements. Maybe this document, as a developer, as a programmer, as a designer, as a database engineer, maybe you are unable to understand. Don't worry. This high level document, the document is called SRS, where a developer perfectly can able to understand about the project means SRS level. What this document contains, a clear explanation is there in the oval symbol. V means system analyst team. So it contains project description, number of modules, modules in high level, modules in low level, all are existed. Once you know SRS document clearly, so you can understand perfectly the business process as well as the technical process of the project. After that, first one, feasibility study or possibility study. A business analyst team involving in this phase to study business requirements or business recs from the client environment will be converted into as a technical document by a professional team is called system analyst team. So system analyst team involving in the second phase is called analysis. They are converting all business recs into system requirements. The document name is called SRS. Software requirement specifications or system recs specs. Any way you can call. So it contains business requirements plus technical requirements. In this one, identify the problem, feasibility study for the new system, investigate current system, that is only current and proposal system and current system. So these two things, how exactly working, we are going to be studying in this phase. There is another phase existed is called designing. The design phase completely done by basis on analysis phase means SRS document. So SRS document base, the designing will be occurred. The designing done in two ways. One is high level designing, another one is the low level designing. High level designing means a project can be divided into main modules. Submodules is nothing but low level designing. So low level designing done by the project leader level people. High level designing done by the project manager category people. So in this document there is a TDD, technical design document. It contains the total design process of the project. So I said already very clearly, main modules done by the project manager and submodules and child modules done by the project leader category people. Based on this designing, means technical design document is input to the next phase. Every phase has input, every phase has output. Input is client requirements here, output BDD, the BDD input here. So once we are going to input BDD and the output will be SRS, business requirements converting into technical requirements. So once SRS is input to in this phase, coming out is TDD, technical design document, that is output and that is input to coding. So in this coding phase, almost all we can say heart part of the project, the real logical part, most essential part is coding. Of course, if I say like this, maybe some of you people again put the comment, above phase not important. No, that is not the meaning of that. Every phase very important. If you compare with our human being body a project, heart is the most important component. Same like that, coding is very important. Logical part of the project. You need to concentrate more and more. A project performance, a project output, everything depends on logic area. So in this phase, a development team is developing the required source code of the project on a specific technology, like maybe any kind of environment we can say here. Presentation layer, business logic layer, data access layer, everything involved in this area. So in this phase done by the, in this phase, white box testing will be done. So white box testing always done by the a development team or a programmer team. A developer is first tester in every software project. Remember that tester is not the first tester. So a first tester is called white box tester. Testing an application with a clear programming and structural knowledge is called white box testing, alias name is clear box testing, alias name is glass box testing. So these are the three popular names existed very clearly here. So once coding part successfully completed without any error, once source code perfectly executed, of many cycles of unit testing or component testing, unit testing alias name, then the module will be generated. Module testing also completed, then it will convert into build, B-U-I-L-D. The build is nothing but the output of the coding module. It is input to the testing. So the build, released build, is going to the testing team. The real black box testing entered in this area. Black box testing is nothing but testing an application without any programming knowledge, with only functional knowledge, is called black box testing. So black box testing team involved here, they are following software testing life cycle and they are testing the application step by step. In another video session separately, I will discuss what is STLC process. So once a testing team received the build, first they are performing smoke testing or build verification testing. What is the meaning of the smoke or build verification testing? As soon as build is released from the development team, testing team checking all major functionalities or basic functionalities properly working or not. If working, they can accept the build. If not working, they reject the build, is called smoke testing. Once the smoke testing succeeded, they'll accept the build. They means testing team. Otherwise, they'll reject to development team. So understand here very clearly what exactly build. Build is nothing but no source code, only executable file. because tester never related to any kind of source code. Once your build smoke testing completed successfully, then you are entering into remaining testing process. Once your testing process successfully completed, then it is going to the next level is called delivery. So remaining types of testing I'll discuss in a separate video session regarding STLC process. Once testing completed is coming to delivery level. What is exactly delivery? Once development success, testing success, the developed project or product is going to the related client or customer, then it is called delivery. Again, the delivery immediately not happened, once succeeded. Here again UAT, user acceptance testing will be occurred. Again UAT classified into two types. One is alpha testing, another one is a beta testing. Alpha means what? Client related person or client is coming to company environment, checking each and every functionality, how application behaving, that is called alpha testing. Means client coming to company location. Once alpha testing successfully completed, the product is delivering to client environment. Before delivered, alpha testing occurred. After delivered and deployed, beta testing happened at the client location with the help of client testers or third party testers. These third party testers are called beta testers. Once beta testing successfully completed, so delivery phase completed, then maintenance phase will be entered. According to our terms and conditions, there is a maintenance module will be come into presentation. What exactly the meaning of maintenance is? Nothing but technical support from the company. So this technical support occurred maybe 50% paid or completely free, depends on terms and conditions between vendor and client. Here vendor means software development company, client is nothing but who is providing the business requirements between these two. But in this software development life cycle, there are the many things existed. Let me explain these things. Stakeholders as well as artifacts, these are the very important things. There are the two types of stakeholders existed. Business stakeholders, who is giving requirements to the company, means client. And technical stakeholders is nothing but vendors who is solving these requirements. So clearly available on your screen, and business stakeholders as well as technical stakeholders. Plus, I wrote very clearly, in every phase, what kind of stakeholder, what kind of artifacts existed. Let me explain very clearly. Feasibility study, business analysis team, BDD, business design document, analysis and system analyst team, subject matter experts, SME means, and SRS, system requirement specifications, designing, I said already, technical analyst team involving, technical design document, coding and development team, and deployed application, EX, I said already that point, testing, testing team or QA team, and quality assurance, and delivery and maintenance, members from development team and quality analyst team. Finally, it is coming software delivery note or tech support. So that is nothing but maintenance environment area. So each and every phase, the related stakeholder, the related artifacts or deliverables, it is a detailed software development life cycle or system development life cycle. Thank you for watching my videos. For more video sessions, subscribe Naresh IT channel.